Shifting our focus to Tamil Nadu now, as violence in Tuticorin enters its fourth day, the DMK and the opposition parties have called for a state-wide bunch today to condemn the police action against civilians and demanding the closure of Sterlite plant in Tuticorin. Centre of Indian Trade Unions has extended support to DMK for the bunch. All auto rickshaws affiliated with CITU to stay off roads today. Remember, 13 people had lost their lives in the last 3 days after police fired at unarmed protesters.
உடனடியாக முதலமைச்சர் செயலிழந்து கிடக்கிற காரணத்தால் அவருடைய முதலமைச்சர் பதவியையும் இந்த ஆட்சியையும் காப்பாற்றிக் கொள்வதற்காகத்தான் அவர்கள் யோசித்துக் கொண்டிருக்கிறார்கள். அதற்காகத்தான் அவர்கள் போராடி கொண்டிருக்கிறார்கள் தவிர மக்களை பற்றியோ இந்த துப்பாக்கிச் சூடு நடந்து ஏறக்குறைய 12 பேர் மாண்டிருக்கிறார்கள் அதை பற்றியோ கொஞ்சம் கூட கவலைப்படாத நிலையில் இருக்கக்கூடிய முதலமைச்சர் எடப்பாடி பழனிசாமி அவர்கள் உடனடியாக ராஜினாமா செய்ய வேண்டும். போலீசினுடைய காட்டுப்பிராணித்தனமான ஒரு நிலைக்கு 12 பேர் குண்டடிக்கு ஆளாகி இறந்திருக்கிறார்களே, அதற்கு பொறுப்பேற்று காவல்துறையினுடைய தலைமை பொறுப்பில் இருக்கக்கூடிய டிஜிபி ராஜேந்திரன் அவர்களையும் உடனடியாக அந்த பொறுப்பிலிருந்து நீக்கிட வேண்டும்.
They are telling lies in order to protect their back.
Who are they protecting, sir? Who is the chief minister?
No, the chief minister, in order to protect themselves, they are telling that some anti-social elements penetrated there, and because of that only this incident happened. It is their fault. It is the intelligence failure. It is the government failure. So he has to step down.
So you just heard there, opposition parties blaming Chief Minister for the unrest. But Chief Minister Palaniswamy yesterday, who spoke to the media, defended the police firing which took place in Tuticorin, calling it an act of self-defense. The Chief Minister claimed that cops had no other option but to open fire to contain the frenzied crowd.
பார்த்து கொண்டு தான் நிற்கின்றோம், நாங்களும் இங்கே தான் இருக்கின்றோம். நாங்கள் அப்போது ஆய்வுக்கூட்டத்திலே இருந்தேன். நீங்கள்லாம் உங்களுடைய ஆய்வுக்கூட்டத்திற்கு நீங்கள்லாம் பத்திரிகையாளர்லாம் வந்து ஊடக நபர்லாம் வந்து என்னை படம் பிடித்தும் போட்டிருக்கேன். நான் இங்கே இருக்கின்றேன். ஐயோ, ஒவ்வொரு முறையும் போராட்டம் நடைபெற்ற பொழுது அமைதியான முறையில் தான் நடத்தினார். ஆனால் இந்த முறை அப்படி அல்ல. வேண்டுமென்றே திட்டமிட்டு நான் ஏற்கனவே குறிப்பிட்டதை போல சில அரசியல் கட்சி தலைவர்கள் சில சமூக விரோதிகளும் இதில் ஊடுருவி இதை பயன்படுத்தி இந்த அரசுக்கு நெருக்கடி கொடுக்க வேண்டும், அவப்பெயரை உண்டாக்க வேண்டும், ஒரு கெட்ட பெயரை உண்டாக்க வேண்டும் எண்ணத்தில் இந்த சூழ்நிலையை உருவாக்கியிருக்கின்றார்கள். ஆகவே இன்றைக்கு ஊர்வலம் வந்தவர்கள் அங்கே இருக்கின்ற காவல்துறையை தாக்கிய பிறகு அவர்கள் முதலிலே கண்ணீர் புகை வீசுகின்றார்கள், பிறகு தடியடி பிரயோகம் செய்கின்றார்கள், பிறகு அதையும் மீறி அங்கே மாவட்ட ஆட்சித்தலைவர் அலுவலகத்தில் இருக்கிற வாகனத்திலும் தீ வைத்து கொளுத்தப்படுகின்றது. அதுக்கு அருகாமையில் இருக்கின்ற ஸ்டெர்லைட் ஆலையினுடைய குடியிருப்புகள் புகுந்து அங்கே இருக்கின்ற வாகனத்துக்கு தீ வைத்து விட்டு அங்கே உள்ளே நுழைய முற்படுகின்றார்கள். மாவட்ட ஆட்சியாளர் அலுவலகத்துக்கு உள்ளே நுழைய முற்படுகின்றார்கள். இதையெல்லாம் உங்களுடைய தொலைக்காட்சியில் பார்த்தா நாங்களும் தெரிஞ்சிட்டோம், ஊடகத்தில் பார்த்தா நாங்களும் தெரிஞ்சிருக்கிறோம். ஏன்னா நாங்கள் இங்கே தான் இருந்தேன், உங்களுக்கு எல்லாத்துக்குமே தெரியும். ஆக இப்படிப்பட்ட நிலவுகள் ஏற்படுகின்ற பொழுது அதை அந்த ஒரு மோசமான சூழ்நிலை நிலவுகின்ற பொழுது ஒரு பதட்டமான நிலை ஏற்படுகின்ற பொழுது இப்படிப்பட்ட நிகழ்வு நடைபெற்றது என்பதை வருத்தத்துடன் தெரிவிக்கிறோம். அதாவது சொல்றீங்க, அனுமதிங்கிறதெல்லாம் இல்லை. ஒரு ஒரு உயிருக்கு உங்களை அடிக்கிறாங்க, டக்குல ஒருத்தர் தடுக்க தான் பார்ப்பாங்க, இதுதான் இயற்கை. இதை யார் திட்டமிட்டு செயல்படுவதே கிடையாது. திட்டமிட்டு செயல்படாத முன்னெச்சரிக்கை சொல்லலாம், முன்னெச்சரிக்கை இப்படி எல்லாம் ஒரு கலவரம் முன்னெச்சரிக்கையாகவே கைது செய்யப்பட்டிருப்பாள்.
You just heard a Chief Minister of Tamil Nadu defending the police action which led to the killing of 13 people. Now shifting our focus to the bunch called by the opposition parties today in Tamil Nadu. And joining me with more details is Shrija from Chennai. Shrija, how much impact can you see of the bunch called by the opposition parties?
Well, Gauri, until late last night, we did, of course, get an information by saying that at least 40% we are going to see the effect over here in Chennai. But looks like it is pretty normal. But however, we see here the public transport that we're talking about is your buses. It is functioning normally, but only a 40% of them. It is going to be a limited access as far as citizens of Chennai are concerned. You normal, even the Auto Association did point to the fact that they will extend their support and also protest against the anti-sterilite. But however, we see even the autos flying here on the roads. But coming back to your private taxis, your taxi aggregators, Ola and Uber, there are very few of them which are flying on this particular road. The place where I'm standing is T Nagar. It is a very popular destination, a business district as far as Chennai is concerned. A couple of shops already have brought their shutters down, but we are also being told that it would take at least another couple of hours to see whether the city is going to see a complete shutdown or not.
Right, Shrija, so we can see that buses and taxis and private auto rickshaws are plying on the roads right now, and some shops are still open, but we have to wait and watch whether this opposition bandh has any kind of impact on state and the operations. And Shrija, just to get more information, also we have been getting reports that massive protests will be staged across the state today, more specifically in Chennai, during the course of the day. So has any kind of special security arrangement been made to handle the situation?
Well, absolutely, you're going to have at least 8 to 10 organizations, including that we are looking at citizen movement organization, who have joined hands with some of the opposition party from the DMK to CPIM, and also several, including Indian National Congress as well, who will come out to the streets, stage protests, shout slogans against the government, the ruling government over here, against especially Chief Minister Edappadi Palaniswamy for the kind of comment that he did make by saying that it was okay, in fact, for the police to open fire. That was just to defend themselves. So what you're seeing right now here is, even though the city is pretty normal at this point in time, we are seeing that tight security. Over 20,000 police personnel have been deployed at certain vantage points. Security towers have also been erected. And then we are also looking at especially city armed force over here, who will be, especially the personnel will be in uniform and plain clothes, will also be deployed across all the sensitive areas. And security has also been tightened around Chief Minister's residence, because remember, we see that all the parties also might, there are high chances that they can walk and march to CM's residence, stage protests, shout slogans. So these are something that you can expect during the course of the day.
Right, Shrija, an action-packed day expected in the state of Tamil Nadu. We will be getting all the updates as it happens, and Shrija will be tracking everything which is going to happen in the state today. Let's shift our focus to the center of action, that is Tuticorin. Take a look at this ground report sent by Shilpa, which paints the real picture right now of the Tuticorin.
Posters like these are a common sight in Tuticorin. This particular poster says, Thangadurai, a youngster, died of cancer because of the harmful pollutants that are released from the Sterilite company. And if I can just ask my video journalist to go through this particular poster, it clearly depicts how people of Tuticorin are suffering because of the extreme levels of pollution that is released by the Sterilite company. And in fact, they're also asking for a ban on the Sterilite company. So this is what the people of Tuticorin are fighting for. They want clean air, clean water, and a life free of diseases. And they're asking the state government to completely shut down the Sterilite plant because it is releasing enormous levels of pollution, which is making life difficult for the people of Tuticorin.
So there you saw a report from Tuticorin sent by Shilpa. And today is the day 4 of the ongoing unrest in the district, and the authorities, which include police and collector, are assuring that the efforts are on to normalize the situation on ground.
The situation in Tuticorin district is much better today. There was a major firing incident day before yesterday, and yesterday also there was one such incident. So there were 13 casualties, and but thereafter a lot of efforts have been taken up by the state government and the district administration to sort out the issues and bring the normality to the district.
See, situation is under control. The officers and men are deployed in the different sectors. Police station, we made every police station a sector. It's all police stations headed by a SP level officer. And the supervisory officer, DIG level, 4 DIG level officers are there. And the sufficient number of the police force have been deployed. So the situation is under control. We are bringing normalcy. We are trying to restore the various facilities like the hotel and markets, selling of the fruits and vegetables. Some group of people are trying to create problem here and there by throwing the petrol bombs. The police force in various sectors, they are trying to control them.
Today, no major incidents. Now it is calm only. At the same time, collector and mine, we would like to go to some of the areas. We would like to interact the
people and all that.
With regards to the facilities, basic facilities for the people, we have taken special care to ensure that Amma Onvagam is open 24/7 for the welfare of patients who are coming to the hospital. Second thing, we are also putting up special Avin booths, milk booths and other basic products from Avin will be available near the hospital. We are having special booths available there. We are also making arrangements for the farm fresh outlets to be open so that the people can buy vegetables from there. Apart from that, drinking water facility availability also we are ensuring. So people who are coming to the GH, all the surrounding areas without facing any problem, all the basic things will be available for them.